Welcome back, everybody. We are back together here with another video, and we're going to be talking about a new documentary that's going to be on Netflix. I don't know if it's out already, but here on Breitbart it says Netflix debuts Cleopatra docuseries, so I'm assuming that is already out. Now, I am a bit fan of Roman history because Cleopatra lived during the Roman times, and Egypt was actually a Roman province, even though Egypt actually still had its own pharaohs there. And for some reason, I don't know why, there's people that actually believe that Cleopatra was black simply because she was actually from Egypt. However, she wasn't even an ethnic Egyptian. You know?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when you think of Africa, do you think of only black people being there?
No.
No. Black people are mainly going to be from sub-Saharan part, below the Sahara Desert. Egypt is above the Sahara Desert. Actually, it's really, really close to Western Asia. It is like right there. And this is actually produced by Will Smith's wife, by the way. I didn't know if you knew that or not.
No.
When you see this, do you know much about the Ptolemy dynasty in Egypt? Because that was the ruling family then at the time.
No, not real.
Okay, so this takes place. I know I'm a history nerd. So Cleopatra was around during the time of Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar and Cleopatra actually did have a son together. His name was Caesario. I can't remember the name exactly. But Cleopatra is actually from the Ptolemaic dynasty. Ptolemy was the general in Alexander the Great's army when Alexander the Great conquered pretty much the known world. They were from Macedonia. They were white. Okay? Just because you're from Africa doesn't mean that you are black. Now, newsflash, you told me this. There's actually Chinese people in Africa, right?
Yeah, they go over there for business and they marry the African women and they have kids, you know. They're like mixed Asian.
That's like a whole country and they're like mixed Asian.
Yeah.
And black. I don't remember the name of the country though. Right.
African and Asian.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, mix. So, you know,
yeah,
Asia and Africa, they are not that far apart.
Right, right. Eastern Asian. I mean, it's kind of like the whole thing with Asian. Like when people say Asia over here, they think of Eastern Asia, but they don't realize that Western Asia has a lot of white people.
Yeah.
Turkey, Armenia, even the Middle Eastern people are technically considered white over here. And some of them are.
Well, in Turkey, like some of the lower part, they look more Asian or something like that.
It could be. Yeah. It could be. But all of that's actually a part of Asia. No, India is a part of Asia.
Mm-hmm.
Tibet is a part of Asia. Mm-hmm. The Middle East is a part of Asia. Russia is a part of Asia. Mm-hmm. All those white people in Eastern Russia are Asians because they're on the Asian continent. That's the way you determine, you know, where somebody's from. That is a part of Asia. But anyway, Cleopatra right here, you can see this picture. They are portraying Cleopatra as pretty much a sub-Saharan African. This was not true. Cleopatra did not look like this. Now, chances are she probably looked white like the Macedonians. You may be saying, all right, they were in Africa. No, when Ptolemy actually came over and he became, because Alexander the Great was the pharaoh of Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
When he got there, he didn't even have to fight. They offered him the crown to be the pharaoh. I believe he stayed there 6 months, maybe 3 months, something like that. Then he left. But when Alexander died around the year 330 BC, his empire was split up among his four generals. Ptolemy took over Egypt and became the pharaoh. And he also adopted Egyptian customs. which means brother-sister marriage. It was a bunch of incest. Even Cleopatra was married to her brother. These people were not black. If anything, they would have had a little bit of North African in them, which is not black. You want to see this trailer?
Yeah.
There's a trailer right here, so we're going to react to it. I have not seen it, but let's play it.
There was a time long ago.
Okay, right there. I think they actually just portrayed all those guys right there look like they're black sub-Saharan African. That's not true.
I'm long ago. When women ruled with unparalleled power as warriors, queens, mothers of nations. And there is none among.
Okay, this picture right here. So that's Cleopatra right there. I don't know who these other people are. And it looks like there are probably some Romans over here on the right side. So.
Among them more iconic than Cleopatra.
I would die for Egypt. What would you die for?
I am Isis. I am a god.
As long as she's alive, she is the pharaoh.
My father's will names me co-ruler of Egypt.
Julius Caesar is aware.
Okay, they got a guy that kind of looks like Caesar. Okay.
That Cleopatra is one of the best educated women in the Mediterranean.
He wants to be king to Cleopatra's queen.
There is no future without the past.
She was using these relationships with Mark Antony to protect herself and her country.
There is no Rome without Egypt.
Cleopatra was trying to save the country that she loved from destruction.
I did what I had to do to protect what is mine.
This is a woman exercising power.
Cleopatra was a Ptolemaic ruler. The very first Ptolemy is a general of Alexander the Great.
It's possible that she was an Egyptian.
I imagine her to have curly hair like me and a similar skin color.
No, she didn't. No, she didn't. Because they adopted the culture of the Egyptians. They were marrying brother and sister. She did not look like him.
I remember my grandmother saying to me, I don't care what they tell you in school, Cleopatra was black.
She has become.
They actually said that.
Wow.
Wow. Okay.
An icon.
I am a god. Queen of kings.
Her story resonates with every woman.
Oh, May the 10th is when it comes out. This is not historically accurate.
But do they know that, the Egyptian, people in Egypt, they have, white, black, different skin color.
If you look at people in Egypt right now, do they look like me?
No,
they don't. They look like almost like a more Middle Eastern kind of people. And also when
some have dark skin, but some of them have darker white,
skin. Some of them have lighter skin.
Also Asian living. Look at the
archaeologists from Egypt. I watched some of his documentaries. What's his name? Zahi Sawa.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like a white dude. He's from Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And in that documentary, they're saying no matter what anybody told you, she's black. How do they know that? There's no evidence whatsoever that Cleopatra was black. When they even said in the documentary herself, she comes from the Ptolemaic line. Ptolemy was a white guy.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe I'll actually have to look at this documentary, but clearly this is not accurate whatsoever, you know? Kind of like what they did with the Anne Boleyn thing. Wasn't that also a Netflix show, if I'm not mistaken? They portrayed Anne Boleyn as black when everybody knew that she was white. I mean, we got paintings of her as clearly white. Also, there's a bust of Cleopatra from the time, and clearly she does not look she doesn't look black. I'm gonna try to look this up. Cleopatra bus. So I want to, yeah. This is a, well, that's not really a, let me go down here. Let me just look at some of these images here. Yeah, like this one here. This is a bus from the time of Cleopatra right there. Definitely not black. Definitely not. She looks like a bunch of other people from the time period with these busts right here. The nose, the features right there. Now, of course, it's a bust that had no photos right here. But she's not black. I don't care what anybody tells you.
No, I always thought she's white.
Because, I mean, she isn't. People look at the movie with Elizabeth Taylor.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it's a movie, but it's definitely more as far as historically what she probably looked like. Now, Elizabeth Taylor was a beautiful woman. Based on the bus, historians believe that, she wasn't that attractive.
Macedonian.
Yeah, she was a Macedonian descent. But also in this trailer, they tried to portray her as like trying to fight for her people or whatever. No, her brother was the king. And she wanted to overthrow a king. That's why she got into a relationship with Julius Caesar.
Yeah,
and when Caesar died, she got with Mark Anthony.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know about this saving her people thing. She was in for it for the power. So I don't know. This is ridiculous right here.
So they are making, is it a movie or a series?
It's a, I believe it's a series.
Series. So
like it's a documentary.
So they are making it like the one where the African woman, the tribe.
Yeah, but that was a movie. I know what you're talking about. You're talking about the Woman King.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, she looks like she belongs in that tribe, but it's not accurate how she looked.
I was wondering if they put like her as a black woman, why not Asian?
Yeah.
Or mixed
Asian. I wonder, why don't they get an Asian? I mean, if they're going to make a, let's say they made a movie about...
Or mixed Asian. I mean,
what black historical figure can I actually talk about? Like, why don't they make... I'm trying to think of a good one here. Why don't they do a movie about Frederick Douglass during the Civil War times and get a white guy to portray him? What everybody would be freaking out, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, Frederick Douglass was actually half white, but still, we know what he actually looks like. We have photographic evidence. What if they made a movie about Hitler? Since we want to have revisionist history, and they had Hitler be portrayed by a Japanese guy. That'd be pretty dumb, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is pretty dumb too. So I don't know. That's all I really got to say about this. You got anything else you want to add to this?
No, it seems like they want to change history or something like that.
Yeah, right. They definitely want to change history. I mean, all we got is the bust to really go off of, but we know that the Macedonians were not black. They were not black. That's just a fact. I mean, there was Macedonians right next to Greece. Those people were white. And that was the ruling family over there. And they had incestuous relationships because that's what the Egyptian ruling class had. They practiced incest. So I highly doubt that she was actually black. But that's going to wrap up the show, guys. We'll be back tomorrow with another video for you guys. Until then, be safe.
Goodbye.